In this video, I'll show you how to make a sponge spicule prep using bleach. We're going to cut a small piece of sponge tissue, dissolve it in household bleach, then rinse it and look at it under the microscope. To get started, make sure you have a lab coat, gloves, and some kind of eye protection or eyeglasses. We're going to use household bleach, water. You'll need a container to hold the waste bleach. I like making these spicule preps in a 24-well tissue tray. You'll need some way to cut the sponge, such as a knife and some forceps. We'll need some microscope slides and cover slips, and also some pipettes to remove the bleach and the spicules. I like using these pipettes where I've cut the end off of one to make it a little bit shorter, but it's also a wider end to the pipette in case you have some very large spicules. Make sure that you label the tray with some kind of number to identify each specimen. To avoid cross-contaminating each specimen, it's a good idea to also label the pipette tips with each specimen. Okay, let's get started. And we'll take our first sponge here. We'll cut a small piece. And you don't need very much here, just maybe half a centimeter cube. We'll put this in the correct well. And then I have these labeled, so I always make a note of which one I'm working on. We'll take this sponge, cut a small chunk off the sponge. Place it in the well. We can then take our household bleach, and you just need to cover up the piece of sponge in each one of these wells. In this case, we're gonna go about half full. Now this bleach will take about 30 minutes to an hour to work. Just depends on how big of a piece of sponge tissue you used or what the exact species of sponge you're using is. After about a half hour, we can come back and we'll see if these are digested. Now that the tissue is dissolved, we can remove the bleach. You just want to use a pipette and carefully suck up this bleach without disturbing the spicules underneath. Okay, once you've removed the bleach, just add some water to each well. And you want to let this sit for about 10 minutes for those spicules to settle back down to the bottom of the well. Now we want to wash these again with water. So we're also going to remove this water. Again, be careful not to disturb the spicules. And you should see a small film on the bottom of the well where the spicules are. Next, we just add more water. We'll rinse these spicules 4 times. Once you've rinsed the spicules, you should see a whitish film on the bottom of the well. Now that we've rinsed the bleach off of these spicules, we can put them onto a microscope slide. I'm going to use some labeled pipettes to do that. I've got one for each specimen so that we don't contaminate the spicules of one species with those from another. And we just suction those up off the bottom. Then it's a good idea to hold the pipette still for a little bit, maybe 15 seconds, before you actually place these on the slide. And now we'll put a cover slip on each slide. Okay, once you've got a cover slip on the slides, we're ready to go look at these in the microscope. So this is our first sponge. And as I look at the slide, I can see mostly oxias. They all have a very similar shape and length and width. And these oxias are basically small curved rods with a point on each end. Our second slide is Eotrichota birotulata, and we can see the very small birotules here. This is at a higher power. This is a 200x magnification. If I go to the previous magnification, which is 100x, you can still see that birotule. This sponge also has a mix of strongyles and styles. In this video, we made our spicule preps using just water as the mounting medium. If you'd like a more permanent spicule prep, you need to use a medium like Canada balsam or permount. You can find protocols for doing this on our website.